This is Raider News Update with Madeline Dollywall and Marisol Paca with the news, Claire Cohen with arts and entertainment, and Dan Lynch with sports. And now, from Studio B at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School, Madeline Dollywall and Marisol Paca.
Welcome to the Period 6-7 edition of Raider News Update. I'm Maddie Dollywell.
And I'm Marisol Paca.
On Monday the 9th, the annual DECA Regional Competition was held at Middlesex County College. Let's find out how the DECA Club did.
Hi, I'm Brooke Enners, here on location with DECA member Amanda Marcus. I heard that you went to the DECA competition.
Yes.
How was that?
It was good. It was a lot of fun. It was a long day, but it was a lot of fun.
And when was it?
It was Monday, January 9th,
Monday. So how did everyone overall through Scotch Plains Fanwood High School place?
Well, a lot of people in our school actually qualified. We got a lot of people in first place, second, third, which is really good considering there's so many schools. So we did pretty well.
Oh, that's great. So how'd you do overall as an individual?
Overall, I did okay. I didn't qualify this year. It was my first year, but I had a lot of fun, and I'm definitely doing it next year.
Well, that's great. Now back to the studio.
Model UN recently attended their annual conference in Hershey Park, Pennsylvania, where they simulated a United Nations General Assembly session. Let's go on location to see how our delegation participated.
Hi, I'm Maddie Dollywall, here on location with student Aiden Racaniello, a member of the Scotch Plains Model UN Club. Aiden, can you tell me a little bit about what Model UN is all about?
Well, Model UN involves students basically replicating what's going on in the real United Nations in New York. And you're going to, in the club, you sign up for a committee and then you get assigned a country. And throughout the months leading up to a conference in Hershey, Pennsylvania, you do research on that country and the topics given. You develop a position that your country's going to take, and you take all that knowledge to Hershey, Pennsylvania, and you debate it out and create resolutions with your colleagues.
All right, and can you tell me a little bit about your experience at the Hershey Park Lodge?
All the schools go to Hershey Lodge for 3 days, and throughout those 3 days, you dress in like business attire, just like they do in the real United Nations, and you write resolutions with your colleagues and try and work towards a common goal to either like create peace or help solve poverty or homeless, like any it could be any topic that the normal UN would debate about. Some of the committees go back in the past and talk about past topics. It's really a lot of fun. You debate different resolutions with your friends and other schools, meet a lot of new people, and it's just really a great experience. And it's very, I think it's very accurate to the real United Nations.
All right, great. And were there any specific awards assigned to the Scotch Plains delegation?
Three of our seniors got a premier delegate, which means that they did some of the best work in their committee. It was Luke Dodge, Eli Ben Michael, and Justin Haas. Junior Dylan Sands received the premier first-year delegate award, which is you did really well as your first year, which is very difficult in speaking in front of a lot of people. And overall, our delegation got a premier delegation award along with a few other schools. So pretty well, great job overall. Oh, and Hansel Romero, he's a sophomore. He got a vice chair, which is a very big achievement.
All right, thank you so much. Good luck with the rest of your year. Now back to the studio.
Did you know that you could check out a DVD copy of any Raider News or Raider News Update newscast from our high school library? In order to communicate the availability, Mr. Hooper wrote a brief commercial featuring our own Matt Kempner and Maddie Dollywall. Hope you enjoy it.
Hey, Maddie, how about coming over to my house after school and maybe watching some TV?
Do you get SPTV on Comcast Channel 34?
No.
Well, do you get SPTV on Verizon Fios Channel 22?
No, I have satellite dish, so we don't get SPTV.
Sorry, Matt. It's nearly 7 o'clock, so I need to go.
You have to be in by 7 o'clock?
No, silly. Raider News comes on at 7. You know I never miss a broadcast. Sorry, Matt, but I need to go.
Wait.
Wait! I just checked out this week's Raider News on a DVD from the high school library. I mean, we can go to my house and watch it tonight.
Well, in that case, Matt, let's go.
Check out Raider News DVDs from the high school library. It just might make your day.
All senior health students are currently participating in the Senior Baby Project. Depending on the health teacher, students will care for a 3-liter soda bottle, a bag of flour, or an egg for a week. Students work in pairs to care for their child and act as though they are actually parents. Health teachers permit their students to use actual baby dolls as long as they weigh enough. Every set of parents is responsible for creating a baby book for their child and documenting their daily activities to be turned in at the end of the week. Let's go on location and talk to some parents.
Hey, I'm Craig Romanoff here, checking out all the senior soda bottle babies, starting first and foremost with my baby, Fakuifui Dufaman Gorbanoff. Fakuifui is sporting an orange diaper, his signature troll face for when he gets into trouble, and my super fuzzy warm hat. Now let's go check out some other babies. Hi, I'm here on location with Emma Cavalieri and her adorable baby. What's the name of your baby, Emma?
Her name is Carly.
Carly. And what is your baby wearing?
I have absolutely no idea.
It looks like it has some pipe cleaners for hair. Is that true?
Yes, he ran out of string.
All right, well, Carly's an adorable baby, and let's go check out another one. So, Robbie Colonna, that's the most beautiful baby I've ever seen.
No, it's not.
I mean, look at his smile. Tell me, who's the baby daddy?
Me.
I'm sorry, the baby mama.
I actually didn't get paired with one because we have outnumbered people in the class.
That is beautiful. That is beautiful. We have a single father right here. So, what's your baby's name?
Patrick.
All right, that is a very beautiful baby. And now let's go see another one. All right, so I'm here with Ezra Klein on location checking out soda bottle babies. So, this is my baby for Fakuifui. Ezra, what's the name of your baby?
Prometheus.
Prometheus. Yeah. Lovely, lovely name for such a lovely baby. What is your baby wearing?
It's wearing a nice combination of a pants, sweatshirt, and onesie.
So, just to be sure, that is not a jumpsuit, right?
It is not a jumpsuit.
Okay. Now, who is the significant other in your baby's life?
Kevin Hessen.
All right, that is a beautiful baby, Prometheus. And now, we got one more baby to show you. So, I'm here on location with Thomas Blue Man Lyons and Steven Garber Farber Flames Garber. So, Garber, what's the name of your baby?
We have a little denim Denise.
Little denim Denise. And you two are the parents?
We are the proud parents.
When did you guys give birth to this wonderful baby?
It was about a week ago. It was a magical day.
And he's dressed in all denim. Any particular reason for that, or just?
I think it looks great, and it's denim's comfortable. Nice carpenter denim. It's a great fit.
It's a great look. Your baby is absolutely gorgeous. Oh, it's going to sleep. It's going to sleep. Okay, we're gonna let it go to sleep. Let's bring it back to the studio.
And now let's go to Quote of the Week. And now let's go to Arts and Entertainment with Claire Cohen.
Thanks, Maddie. The top 5 movies to see in theaters are number 5, Alvin and the Chipmunks, Chipwrecked. Number 4, The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. Number 3, Sherlock Holmes. Number 2, Mission Impossible. And counting down at number 1, The Devil Inside. The top 5 songs this week are Party Rock Anthem by LMFAO. Number 4, Set Fire to the Rain by Adele. Number 3, Good Feeling by Flo Rida. Number 2, We Found Love by Rihanna. And counting down at number 1, Sexy and I Know It by LMFAO. The Blue Diamond Step team continues to compete and show off their talents. Let's go on location to find out more.
Hi, I'm Natalie Smith, and I'm here with Ambry Thompson on the Step Squad. So, Ambry, tell me how your last competition was.
The competition was really good. We played second place under Carteret. They're really good. It was 7 teams there, I believe, so 2nd out of 7 is pretty good.
That's cool. So, when's your next competition?
Our next competition is on the 21st, on Saturday, and it's at Bayonne High School.
So how do you think you're going to score?
We're hoping to take first place like we usually do, but it's kind of got harder. There's a lot of better teams this year, so we don't know. Everything's a little confusing, but we're going to take first.
So what new teams this year that are, like, really good and competitive?
I don't really remember the names of them. There's some from down in Seaside, Atlantic City, and stuff like that. We saw them on Saturday, and it was just, like, so much new stuff that we've never seen before, so it was good.
Good. So how are you preparing for the next competition?
We practice every single day, even on Christmas. We practice every day from 9 to sometimes 4, 6, stuff like that.
That's cool. Thank you, and back to the studio.
Now let's go to Critics Corner with Matt Kempner and Tyler Pace.
Hi, I'm Matt Kempner, and welcome to an all-new edition of Critics Corner. With me is Tyler, filling in for Tom. And this week we saw the new horror movie, The Devil Inside. Tyler, give me a quick plot summary of this movie.
It's a mix of The Exorcist meets Spider-Man. There's a lot of wall climbing and you know, levitating off the ground. It's very interesting to see how the director went with this, to see him, you know, how he made, you know, the blood and the gore in the movie. It was very interesting.
Now, the movie is filmed documentary style, much like Cloverfield and other films in that genre, which isn't my favorite because it can lead to nausea, you know, when the camera's shaking so much and you don't know what to do in the audience. I'm not a huge fan of horror movies, especially in the exorcist kind of genre. You know, I feel like it's kind of overdone, and I feel like when they mix the religion and the horror, you know, it never touches me. You know, Tyler, what would you say your view of the movie is? What do you think?
Well, I agree with you when the Cloverfield kind of documentary style made me a little nauseous. I didn't really get to watch a lot of the movie. I had my hands over my eyes a lot of the time, and you know, so I saw, you know, bits and pieces of it. It was very scary. You know, it was okay.
Yeah. That's it was okay. You know, as a fan of film, and you know, I give this movie three devils inside five. What do you give it?
I give this 2.5 demons out of five.
You heard it from the best. Back to the studio.
Now let's go to Weekend Preview with Sarah Hayden and Kelsey Matamore.
Hi, I'm Sarah Hayden.
And I'm Jackie Isola.
And this is your Weekend Preview. For sports this weekend, there will be a boys varsity bowling tournament at Brunswick Zone and a boys varsity basketball tournament versus Union City High School. On Sunday, there will be a boys and girls varsity indoor track tournament versus Toms River.
This weekend in the box office will be Beauty and the Beast 3D, Contraband, and Joyful Noise. Coming out on DVD releases are Killer Elite, Boardwalk Empire, and Moneyball.
Thank you. This has been your Weekend Preview. Now back to the studio.
And now let's go to sports with Dan Lynch.
Thanks, Marisol. The NFL playoffs started this past weekend. The New York Giants beat the Atlanta Falcons 24-2, the Saints beat the Lions, and the Texans won their first ever postseason game against the Bengals. And in an overtime shocker, Tim Tebow and the Broncos upset the Steelers. Let's go on location to find out students and staff reactions for this upcoming weekend.
I'm here with senior Joey Schmidt. So, Joe, what team were you rooting for this playoffs?
I'm rooting for the New York Giants.
And they had a big win. What do you think about that?
They played exceptionally well. Their defense didn't even let up any points. The only 2 points Atlanta scored came from a safety. So if they play like that, they'll be fine throughout the playoffs.
And yes, it was a good game. What do you think their chances are next round?
If they play defense like they did in the Atlanta game, their chances are really good, because Green Bay does not have the best passing defense, and Eli can expose that.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Tom, let's talk some football. Did you watch any games this weekend?
Yeah, I watched my favorite team, the Denver Broncos, beat the Steelers on Sunday. It was an amazing game in overtime led by Tim Tebow.
So a little bit about Tim Tebow. How do you think he played?
Well, Tim Tebow, with his 316 passing yards, had what I would say a heck of a game. He threw that pigskin around like it was nobody's business. And I think if the defense continues to play the way it is, they're going to go all the way, Tim Tebow all the way.
And they had a crazy overtime victory. What was your reaction to Tim Tebow during that?
Well, my initial reaction was that huge bomb was the hand of God coming down and blessing Tim Tebow with his presence. Go Broncos.
And they're playing the Patriots next week in the next round of the playoffs. How do you think Tim Tebow and the Broncos are going to do against Tom Brady and the New England Patriots?
Well, Tom Brady is a master quarterback, but it's definitely going to be difficult for Tim Tebow to rise up against the challenge, and I think he should be doing fine.
All right, thank you, Tom, and back to the studio.
The girls' varsity basketball team is off to a 5-3 start. With star guard Taylor Sebleo, the team looks to increase their 3-0 record in the county with an upcoming game against Summit. The rest of the team is off to a 9-0 start. With key starters like heavyweight junior Anthony Tafaro and freshman phenom Brian Lapham, the team looks to stay undefeated. I recently caught up with Brian to find out how this weekend went for the team.
Hi, I'm on location with freshman Brian Lapham on the wrestling team. Brian, why don't you tell me a little about this weekend?
This weekend was good. The team won all three matches, and so did I. So it was good. A lot of new kids that I haven't seen in a while. So.
And who'd you guys go against?
We wrestled Morris Hills, Parsippany Hills, and Whippany Park in a quad.
And what is the team record currently?
9-0.
9-0. Wow. Back to the studio.
That wraps up for sports. Now back to Maddie and Marisol.
Let's zoom on over to Car of the Week.
How are you now?
Vince.
And I'm Cormier Philippe.
And this is Car of the Week. We're here with Travis Cortez's 5 Series BMW. Fresh and white.
Let's see what we got under the hood. See here, he has a V6 engine. Some heavy duty stuff going on. A lot of horsepower. See, Travis has some pretty good tints. They're dark, but not too dark. Enough for privacy.
Here we got some 17-inch Monterey blacked out rims.
You see, Travis has a lot of space in the back for two 12-inch JBLs that bump.
Here inside Travis's Beamer, there's some fresh beige leather. He's got a crazy audio and navigation system, as long as a heads up display, so he doesn't need to be looking down and always concentrating on the road. I'm Alex Markovitz.
I'm Cormier Fleet.
I'm Travis.
And this is our Car of the Week.
And now let's go to weekend weather with Stormy Sebs.
Oh, look, it's Stormy Sebs with this weekend's weather update.
Hi, I'm Stormy Sebs with your weekend weather. On Saturday, we have a high of 37 and a low of 28. And on Sunday, we have a 68% chance of flurries with a high of 28 and a low of 18. This has been your weekend weather. Now back to the studio.
That wraps it up for the Period 6-7 edition of Radio News Update. Be sure to stay tuned for a repeat of last week's Period 4-5 edition.
This is Raider News Update with Nick Lukowski and Christy Leese with the news, Caitlin Unin with Arts and Entertainment, and Elizabeth Schiller with Sports. And now, from Studio B at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School, Nick Lukowski and Christy Leese.
Hello and welcome to the Period 4-5 edition of Raider News Update. I'm Nick Lukowski.
And I'm Christy Leese. Starting up in the new year, Spiffy High students have committed to all kinds of New Year's resolutions. Let's go on location to find out what students plan to accomplish in 2012.
My New Year's resolution is to stop biting my nails.
My New Year's resolution is to go to bed earlier.
My New Year's resolution is to get better grades.
My New Year's resolution is to not leave grading to the last minute.
My New Year's resolution is to be a better person.
My New Year's resolution is not to lose my wallet every track practice.
My New Year's resolution is to volunteer more, especially at the Special Olympics in New Jersey.
My New Year's resolution is not to get arrested.
My New Year's resolution is to be nicer to people.
My New Year's resolution is not sweat the little things.
My New Year's resolution is to keep my room clean.
Pay all of my bills.
My New Year's resolution is to drive slower.
My New Year's resolution is to start figuring out how this physics stuff works.
On Thursday, December 22nd, JSA held its second Master Debater competition of the year. This time, previous winner Jason Fortunato was unseated by senior Matt Monroy. Let's go on location with Craig Orbanoff for more information.
Hi, I'm Craig Orbanoff here on location with Matthew Lewis Monroy, also known as Matt Monjoy, the Master Debater of JSA's Winter Master Debater competition. Matt Monroy, how do you feel about being once again the Master Debater?
I feel great. I feel like I've made it to the top. I feel like I've crushed everybody beneath me, and I showed no mercy.
That's great. I hear in the tournament you dethroned the two-time champion, Jason Fortunato.
Two-time champion. He tried. Tried to take me over. Tried to keep his throne, but in the end, I gave out on top.
Now, for the people at home who do not know what Master Debater is, you want to tell us a little bit about the process?
Master Debater, or Debate Master, is a tournament in JSA. We are the local debate club, and we have a tournament of, they're like usually like 1 or 2 minute long debates, and they're short and stupid, like rename America, North Mexico, or South Canada. And one side takes one position, and the other side takes another position, and we just debate. And whoever's the funniest or the wittiest moves up. And then when you get to the final round, you go against the previous master, which was Jason Fortunato, and I beat him.
All right, and now you're a senior. You've been all 4 years in JSA. This is your first Master Debater throne. Do you feel you've reached the peak of the mountain?
Yes. You know, there's a lot of positions I could have. I could have been president, or I could have done something that like actually impacted the club, but only a few people can say they've been Master Debater.
That's very true. Not too many people can be the one and only Master Debater. Thank you, Matt Monroy. That wraps it up here. Now back to the studio.
During gym classes on January 27th, students will observe and take part in the annual Relay for Life kickoff. Hosted by SMAC, the kickoff will feature videos and SMAC officers informing the students about how to prepare and sign up for 2012's Relay for Life. There will even be some interactive activities to get the crowd involved.
As the world welcomes 2012, the Scotch Plains Rescue Squad will memorialize its 75th year of uninterrupted volunteer emergency medical service to the community. When the squad was first formed in 1937, it had just a handful of members trained in advanced first aid work. Currently, the squad has over 90 members who answer approximately 1,100 emergency calls per year. The squad relies on ongoing community support only from tax-deductible donations.
Coming up this month, on January 16, 2012, volunteers of all ages are encouraged to take part in the Martin Luther King Day of Service. From 10 to 11 a.m., there will be an opening program and registration at the JCC on Martine Avenue. Then from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m., the service activities will commence throughout the Scotch Plains Fanwood area. For more information, please visit www.spfmlkday.com.
3 months ago, NASA launched its latest mission to the moon. Now, traveling 2.5 million miles, the twin Grail A and Grail B space probes have reached lunar orbit. Researchers expect the Grail probes to return detailed maps of the moon's uneven gravitational field and further insight down to its core. The mission is expected to give scientists an unprecedented amount of new information on Earth's orbital companion and is expected to end sometime in March this year.
And now let's go to Quote of the Week.
And now let's go to Arts and Entertainment with Caitlin Buna.
Top 5 songs of the week are Set Fire to the Rain by Adele, Good Feeling by Flo Rida, It Will Rain by Bruno Mars, We Found Love by Rihanna, and the number one song of this week is Sexy and I Know It by LMFAO. The top 5 movies of the week are We Bought a Zoo, The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, Alvin and the Chipmunks Chipwrecked, Sherlock Holmes A Game of Shadows, and the number one movie of this week is Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. The Boys of Rep Theater have a new challenge this year as the new production Anything Goes requires them to learn tap dances for multiple numbers. I caught up with a few cast members to see how this went.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Venan on location with sophomore Hansel Romero. So, Hansel, tell me about the tap dance that you have to take for rep class.
Well, we go to GISA's Studio Dance 2000 every couple of weeks and do a workshop with the entire cast.
Oh, that sounds awesome. And do you do it out of school or in school?
We do it out of school.
And do you like taking the tap class?
It's actually a lot of fun, yeah. I like learning tap because she's a very good teacher and it's a lot of fun to try to learn something you've never tried before.
All right, awesome.
And now let's go to Critics Corner with Craig Gorbunov.
Hey, I'm Craig Gorbunov. Welcome to this week's edition of Critics Corner. So, this week I went to go see Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol, starring Tom Cruise, of course. This movie did really well review-wise, and I'm going to give it a good review as well. Tom Cruise did a really good job acting. He was also a producer, and I feel he put it together really well, and it stayed true to that, you know, that Mission Impossible action movie feel. There was some really cool action scenes in it where the bomb goes off in Russia and the building just explodes. It was really awesome. All the other performances were really good. There was a lot of good comic relief in there to go along with the seriousness of the movie. And everything just really worked. And it was keeping true to the classic series. And I don't think this was the conclusion. I think there's going to be another Mission Impossible. but this one was definitely very good. Nice part to the series. I'm going to give it 4 out of 5 stars just because, I don't know, it wasn't like spectacular like a lot of the other Oscar-worthy movies I've seen, but this was still really good, really enjoyable, worth seeing. That wraps it up here for Critics Corner. Now back to the studio.
And now let's go to sports with Liz Schiller.
Thanks, Chrissy. Over break, senior Erin Pierce broke the school record for the 1,000 meter. Her time was 3 minutes, 7 seconds, and 48 milliseconds. Let's go to Erin to see how she feels.
On location with track sensation, Erin Pierce. Erin, I heard you broke a record this weekend.
Yes, I did.
Can you tell me about it?
I broke the 1,000 meters record, which it was indoors, so that's 5 laps, and on outdoor track it would be 2.5 laps.
I heard there was something special about this record, that this is a race you don't normally run. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, every single winter there's this one meet where we kind of run like different events, and this is only the second time that I've ran this event.
All right, cool. And have you broke any other records?
Yeah, last spring I broke the 1600 meter record and the 800 meter record.
All right, thanks, and back to studio.
The boys basketball team defeated the Woodbridge Barons in their holiday tournament. The final score was 55-54 with 9 seconds left. On Monday the 2nd, the varsity hockey team tied Cranford 2-2. With 39 seconds left in the game, they scored. Now back to Nick and Chrissy.
And now let's go to Car of the Week.
I'm Evan Lebransky.
And I'm Michael Villegas, and this is Car of the Week.
Today we have Tyler Pace's 2002 Toyota Sequoia. Sequoia is white and has a nice V8 engine. Nice leather seats with the wood finish and some nice speakers and very spacious and 3 rows behind us.
Yo, I try to get it how I live it. A lot of people counting on me kind of like a digit. It's a cold world. I'm not fronting like it isn't. It's no time for coming up shorter than the midget.
I'm Evan Lebransky. I'm Michael Villegas. Like, and this was your car.
If a star go don't blink, you might miss it. It's precious cargo. You got to be strong to lift it. The light comes a different.
That wraps it up for the Period 4-5 edition of Radio News Update.
School and maybe watching some TV.
Do you get SPTV on Comcast Channel 34?
No.
Well, do you get SPTV on Verizon Fios Channel 22?
No, I have satellite dish, so we don't get SPTV.
Sorry, Matt, it's nearly 7 o'clock, so I need to go.
You have to be in by 7 o'clock?
No, silly, Radar News comes on at 7. You know I never miss a broadcast. Sorry, Matt, but I need to go.
Wait! I just checked out this week's Radar News on a DVD from the high school library. We can go to my house and watch it tonight.
Well, in that case, Matt, let's go.
Check out Raider News DVDs from the high school library. It just might make your day.